Who named Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam with the name Sayyiduna Abdul Muttalib radiyallahu an, the grandfather of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam? It is our position that the ancestors of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam were believers, that the direct ancestors were believers. There is no proof to show that Abdullah radiyallahu an and Sayyidatuna Amina radiyallahu anha were disbelievers or polytheists. People cite two narrations to prove this the counterposition. One narration is in the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari, and one narration is in the Sahih of Imam Muslim. The one in the Sahih of Imam al-Bukhari, Inna abi wa abaka fi an-nar, which is literally, my father and your father are in the fire. But the context of this narration is not mentioned. And this addition of Inna abi is an isolated addition of one narrator. An isolated addition of one narrator. If you check the same hadith with other chains of transmission, other narrators from Thabit al-Bunani, you will find that none of them add the addition of Inna abi, surely my father. None of them add this wording. Only one narrator adds this wording. And therefore the wording is considered an anomaly and is not accepted. It is considered a mistake of the narrator. That one, those two words, Inna abi, those are considered as a mistake of the narrator. As for the second hadith, which is that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to visit the grave of his mother Sayyidatuna Amina radiyallahu anha and was prevented from supplicating for her, we say in response to this, prevention of supplication is not a proof for the disbelief of the mother of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why? The reason for preventing the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from supplicating was because Sayyidatuna Amina radiyallahu anha is from those selected servants who are from Ahlu La ilaha illallah. They are the people who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself, without intercession, shall save from hellfire. What do we mean by this? If you check the long narration in Bukhari regarding the intercession, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will continue interceding for people until he reaches a group of people regarding whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will say, I myself will take out of hellfire without the means of intercession. So Sayyidatuna Amina radiyallahu anha is from those people of La ilaha illallah. This is why the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was prevented from supplicating for her. If she was a polytheist, then the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would have been prevented from even visiting the grave, because there is a clear prohibition from even visiting the graves of the polytheists. So Abdul Muttalib radiyallahu an is also from those individuals who passed away on monotheism, Tawheed. Shirk, polytheism is not proven from him. And remember, this issue as well, unfortunately some people from the pseudo-Salafi movement of the modern era have claimed that this issue is from the issues of principles of religion, to believe that the parents passed away in disbelief, when in reality this is not an issue of the principles of the religion. A very small number of people held that position, while the majority of scholars either remained silent or held the position that they passed away either from the people of Ahlul Fatra, the people of the gap meaning the period of time in which no prophets came, or they died on monotheism or on the religion of Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salam. So this is an issue which should not be disputed by the modern pseudo-Salafi movement.